Hey y'all! Today I'm going to do a get ready with me chit chat. I hope this is not blurred, but I'm doing a get ready with me chit chat. I have a couple things that I want to talk about, so we're going to get right into it. I'm not going to have this video longer than 20 minutes, maybe 25. But yeah, so I have someone to meet, but let me get situated. Alright, so the first thing I wanted to talk about is, I don't know, let me see. I don't know, I hate when you put all your all into a grade or, I mean, a class or whatever, and the results still don't end up the same. And it's like, what am I supposed to do? And it's one of my classes, well, two of my classes, one of the professors actually is like taking the time out to help me understand it. And I feel, and I have like a, let's just say it's a low grade. So, it's probably like a 55 right now. And I just took the exam a few days ago, but he was helping me out, you know, for the past month so I can understand it. And so you know, I really like that about him. So I actually feel like I can pull up that 55 to a C more than I can with the class that I have like a D in to a C. That makes sense, because the other professor is like, she's very, I don't want to say anything, it's just like, she doesn't care, if that makes sense. And I email her several times, and it's like, what am I supposed to do? And she grades the papers so freaking hard. It's like, if she does not like your topic or your title, she would take points off it. And it's like, really? Like, don't grade me on my opinion or whatever. Grade me of the facts and the presenting. Or it will be something minor. And I'm like, really? Is it that serious? Like a comma, is it that serious? And this is one of the main reasons why I decided not to major in English, because it's like, it's so many rules, and I don't know like how you can remember all those rules like that. And I remember when I was like in middle school, I used to play teacher, and like one of the classes, like the teacher I wanted to be was an English teacher. Because I can understand, you know, English a little bit better, but it is so many rules, and it's like, I can't keep up with them, and it's like, and then I'm not a good, like, speaker, and like, I have a slurred speech because I have, like, gaps, and my teeth are weird, but it always has been that way, so it's like, I decided not to be an English teacher anymore. So I'm like, I always wanted to teach elementary, like, I just wanted to be a teacher. I wanted to teach elementary, middle school, like high school. I just want to be a teacher. Now, if I wanted to talk like middle school or high school, it would probably be something like history. Now, if I do decide to, you know, go into the middle grades, whatever, it would probably be like like social studies or history. I probably can teach math more than I can teach English, and I'm not good at math. But it's like, it's so many rules. Like, I can remember the math rules way better than I can with English, and it's like, I can't, like, and it's been a long time since I took a English class, so it's like, or math class, so it's really like slowly coming back to me. And it's just, I don't know, I'm just ready to graduate. I am so ready to freaking graduate. Like, where is my degree? 2019, used to hurry up. Now, I would have graduated next year, 2018, but it was some things that happened, and it's like, really? So I would have graduated 2018 with my class. So, yeah, and it's like, I struggled so much to get to college, and I cried. Like, I think education is very important, And if I don't graduate with my degree, bachelor's degree, I'm gonna be so devastated. It's like I put all this work, all these tears, all this stress, trying to get here for a teacher to take off some points off of some bull crap. Like, are you serious? And it's like, you have been to college before, but she's a little bit older, so it's been a long time. And I don't think they had computers like that, but, you know, in my opinion, I think back in the day, college was a little bit more easier for people who are, like, older, who had, degrees. It was easier. They can deny what it is. Like, it is. And I noticed how, like, some of the older generation, they always have been doing this, you know, back in my day, whatever. But the thing is, today, it's a lot harder. Meaning, the school system, for example, like, the college, these loans, like, you telling me you have to pay all these loans back in the day? You didn't. So you have to outweigh the circumstances back in the day and today. And I don't think a lot of them actually think about that, too. But shame, no shame. And I hate when folks think when someone who's younger is actually telling the truth, they actually see that as talking back. Even when little kids say, like, I had misspelled a word on the board, and that was in my observation, and, like, I misspelled the word. But most people will see that you're talking back because you got it wrong. Like, they're just saying, this is wrong, and I don't understand that. It's like, if you're wrong, you're wrong. It doesn't matter what age you are. You're wrong. So, I'm like, thank you, guys. You know. Yeah. So, I mean, kids can teach you some things, too. I need to buy more foundation. Like, let me go this way. Okay, so what else I wanted to talk about? Why is it so hot in here? Like, okay, what else I want to talk about? So the other day, I say like last week or something, I have been getting like hate comments, and like I delete them before anybody can see. Sometimes I leave it up there, and sometimes I don't. And I just block the person. But this is what I don't understand when people leave these hate comments. If you don't like my video, why keep watching? And the same thing with the thumbs down. If you don't like someone else's video, why you don't click off? I want somebody to answer it. Why you don't click off? That says one time that I type videos how to make a sandwich or something. If I don't like the video, the first, because sometimes I skip, I'm clicking off. Like, I'm clicking off. There is no thumbs down. There's no hate comment involved. I didn't bring my brushes, and I need to go back. But it's like, if you don't like my video, click off. It's really not that hard to understand. Click off. Hold on, let me get my brushes, because I didn't bring them here. Click off. I really need to clean my brushes. And I need to wash my hair. Like, I haven't washed my hair in, like, almost 2 weeks. Or co-wash or nothing, like, none of that. And usually I wash my hair every, like, at the end of the week. But it's, like, it's a lot of time. And, like, these past weeks, I've been busy. And it's, like, it takes, like, my weekends for the past week, I had to do something for my major and stuff, for my class. And it's, like, I have to study, I have to work on this, and that, and it's like, you know, a lot of people who have really long hair, whatever, they don't wash their hair like that, all like that. And let's just say if I had cornrows or something in my hair, I'm not gonna wash my hair every week. So, I mean, my hair hasn't been, like, terribly itchy or anything like that, because I use apple cider vinegar, and it really gets rid of everything on your scalp. And, you know, I use that, so I will be washing my hair this weekend with the apple cider vinegar. Make sure I put a lot, because I want to rinse all of these products out of my head. All of it. And I do have the ABC rinse video already uploaded on my channel. But yeah, so back to the other conversation. But the thing about the hate comments and stuff, or whatever. If you don't like someone's video or channel, you can always unsubscribe. I mean, there's a lot of people who unsubscribe from my channel too. So it's like, bye. Like, if you don't like what I'm saying, bye. The same thing with, like, you know, life in general. Well, sometimes you can't withdraw from things. But if it's like people in your life that who are making your life terrible, you have the option to not talk to them or socialize with them anymore. You have that option. And some people are so desperate to have people around them. If you don't want to be around me, you can leave. Like, why would I want someone around me who don't like me? Or why would I want to be around someone who I don't like? My brushes, I need new makeup brushes because they break and it's like... Okay. Alright, but okay, so it was one comment I have gotten and it was like, it was my olive oil, eco style olive oil video, and the person was like, because I had Snapchatted it, so it was like 4C hair. I can't remember the exact words, but I'm summarizing. That 4C hair does not look good, or something like that. Eco styler leaves my hair crunchy and whatever. What else? Eco styler leaves my hair crunchy. I did it. My hair looked worse than yours. Blah blah blah. And then I commented and I'm like, this is what a lot of people do. They will comment on people's videos and they will basically do this self like reflection thing or deflection or something. For example, they would come off like, oh, I'm confident on it. You really not. People need to actually understand what is confident. But if you go over that video, you actually see what I said, because I did not delete it. But I replied back to the person, and I was like, you know, if you're so confident, like, you know, I can't remember. It was like, people who like to see people down, they will say something negative to you or come into my video to make themselves feel good. And the person will come in, well, I have long 4C hair, darn. Why are you on my video if you have, like, it's like, if I know I'm fine, why would I come in with somebody saying you ugly and all that? Obviously, you don't think you that dang fine. So, it's like, nobody didn't tell you to come in my video. Now, do I like when people come in my video? Yes, you know, but you're not obligated. Most of the time, people don't come in my videos. They watch it. They don't come in. But it's like, I like it when you guys come in. But if it's some negative bull crap, you can take it up with them. Like, you don't need to have it on my video. Like, seriously. And I noticed that when your channel starts to gain views and things like that, you're going to get more haters. You're going to get more hate. It is what it is. It comes with the price. It's like when you're becoming famous, you're going to get hate underneath your Instagram photos. It's to be expected. And this is one of the things I'm thankful for being bullied when I was young. If I wasn't bullied in my younger years, if that person would have left that comment, I wouldn't take that to heart. Like, I wouldn't take it to really to heart, because let's just say if your whole life you've been told you're beautiful, you this your whole entire life, when someone says something that you like that's opposite, you would take it to more to heart, because your confidence is based on what someone is telling you, not that you actually feel that way. But people who have been bullied in the past or whatever, they know how to take those hardships like more than you do, because they're used to it. So I'm really thankful for my bullies back in the day. Now, it wasn't that kind of bullying. You didn't put your hands on me. It was like talking crap and then go off. But the thing is, so I'm really thankful for it because it gave me muscles. It built me muscles. So the people that who bullied me, thank you. Like, thank you. Because it showed that you had bad, like, you had low self-esteem. That's the reason why you did it. It was a chit-chat video I did about, like, the reasons why people bully. It comes from a place of low self-esteem, low self-worth. They feel better bullying someone because at home they're mistreated. They might, you know, dealing with abuse and things like that, which is actually sad. But they take it out on people who aren't doing it. And they attack the people who maybe seem as weak or whatever. And when you retaliate, they want to play the victim, whatever. It's like, basically, you hit someone. You keep hitting someone. You keep hitting someone. And you think it's funny. But as soon as they beat your tail, then you want to cry and play the victim. Yeah. So, it's kind of like that, but if you don't like my content, you really don't have to watch. You can unsubscribe. I want the people to subscribe to my videos who actually like my content. If you don't like my content, why are you watching? You don't have to subscribe at all. And, you know, it's really simple. You don't have to watch my videos at all. I mean, I love my subscribers. I really do. And I have a couple subscribers who inbox me on Instagram. My lips are so white. They inbox me on Instagram, Snapchat. I'm thinking about making a new Snapchat just for YouTube. And those people, they know who they are. I mean, you know who you are. But it's like, those are the types of people. And it's just a handful of people. It's not that many. But it's like, those are the types of people who are my real Ride or Die subscribers. And like, I really want to say their names. But that's, I won't do that. But it's like, wow. So, I'm really thankful for you guys. And it's one lady, you know, the most. I don't know if I want to get her name. Cause I don't know. But she her name started with an M. She knows who I'm talking about. But the thing is, it's like, I'm really like, ooh, I don't want to cry on this video. I'm really thankful for true subscribers who actually love my content, who actually watch my videos. I can put up a video about this, they will watch it, and I love that. And I remember when I had Snapchatted about, you know, I just wanted to graduate, when is the date? And the lady was like, you know, push it through. I mean, basically, you know, keep going, like, it's gonna come, you know, it's worth it and stuff like that. And I know that, but sometimes I can be my own worst enemy sometimes. Even though I'm gonna still keep going, but sometimes I'm like, when is it gonna hurt yet? So I also have to think about that as well. I'm not the most perfect person at all. Girl, I'm far away from perfect. So, you know, it's good to have subscribers and people in your life who can remind you. I mean, it's worth it. Like, people who go to college, they deal with the same thing you're dealing with. So it's like, you'll be okay. Go home with your life. And another person, he's not a subscriber or nothing, but he works at the place here. And, like, I'm one time, he comes to me, you know, and he'll be like, hey, how are you? Like, how everything been going? I'm, like, stressed. And, you know, or I'm like, everything's good. You know, I have this and this going on. You know, normal talk. I'm going to keep it real. If I'm bothered, I'm going to tell you sometimes. And he's like, you know, it took me 5 years to, you know, graduate, you know, from college and all, and I had, like, 2 kids, and, you know, I had to go back to school to get my GED. He was like, if I can do it, you can do it. And I'm like, thank you. Sometimes you need to actually hear somebody's situation, how they was dealing with it worse when they was in school, to actually say, the stuff that I'm crying about and I'm mad about is bullcrap. So it's like, you know, thank you. He was like, you know, everything will be alright. It will pay off in the end. Even though I know that, but sometimes you actually forget that in certain situations or certain days. So I just messed up my whole entire eyebrow. But who cares? But you need good people in your life. You need real people. Real people who don't agree with you all the time in your life. Who don't have the same beliefs as you. The same religion. The same political party or whatever. And people let that stuff get to them so deeply. It's like, really? Like, are you serious? Now, in certain parties, you know, certain beliefs. Not like religion beliefs. But I'm talking about like, you know, racist beliefs. That you don't want to be part of, that I don't want to be part of, but that's totally different. Why do we even put this on? It's so natural they got on. But like I was saying, it's good to have people who actually genuinely cares about you. So yeah. So that was that. Okay, I can't find what I'm looking for. I'm still trying to find a job, y'all. But I have an interview. I have an interview next week. And I don't want to say what the position is yet until I get it. But I can't wait. I'm nervous. I'm really nervous. I'm trying this Marc Jacobs crap. It's supposed to be the highlighter, the dewdrops foundation. The thing I just showed you earlier. I'm going to see how this looks. Look, that's too much product. What am I going to do with this? Where's the napkin? Okay, I'm going to come right back. Okay, it looked the same. I probably should have put more, but for anywho, okay, let's set the subject that I want to talk about. Been a little bit more social, not really, but more social, you know. So I have been talking to a couple of people, not only that, you know, with that too, but I have been talking to a lot of people, and you know, I'm very antisocial. I love being alone. And that's one thing. Some of y'all gotta learn how to love to be alone. It's like people need to be in cliques to feel like they somebody. Girl, bad. Like, stop. But I'm one of those people, I like to be myself. And some people don't like people who don't want to follow the trends. For example, I'm probably gonna offend some people. Let's say if I go to a club and they're gonna play what type of genre? Most of the time they're gonna play hip hop or rap. If I go to the club, I won't know none of the songs. I'm gonna keep it real. I don't know most of the songs. They be like, did you listen to blah 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 or Carter Black? I'm like, I don't know who that is. I really don't. Like, they be saying this, I don't know who that is. I know 21 Savage. I just listened to two songs in here. But it's like, I don't know these people. And people be like, what? Like, how y'all know who he is? Because I'm not a follower. I don't follow what other people think that is trendy. That's not me. You might be a follower, not I. And I would say that, and like, I listen to, and I'm like, I don't know if it's because I'm black. That if I listen to another genre of music, because most of the time if I listen to music, it's mainly I hate when somebody park right there and they look at me in the face and they sit in the car for a long time, and it's really weird. This is so weird, but but I really like this. It gives me that moisturized lip. Okay, but yeah, so I don't like, if it was to me, if someone said which kind of type of music you want to listen to, heavy metal or hip hop, I'm sorry, I'd go with heavy metal. Not because I just want to be different, it's just I like heavy metal music more than hip hop. Like, shade, no shade, like, I really don't like it like that. I mean, I don't listen to it, but it'd be like the old songs. Like, even when I was in middle school or whatever, I didn't follow what people thought was popular. It's like, it's not me. Like, I'm not a follower. You follow me on Snapchat, I listen to like different types of music, but I don't listen to like one genre or the normal genre that people with my skin complexion listen to. It's not my type. They don't like heavy metal, which I think is brilliant. But I'm like, how come you don't like heavy metal? Now, not all heavy metal I listen to, because some of it go too hard. And I'm like, okay, I'm not about that life. So it goes hard. Like, you listen to that really hardcore heavy metal, it make you want to do something that you don't want to do. I just threw shade. I don't care. And if you say something that I don't like, I'm going to come back at your comment, and you ain't going to like it. So yeah, what is this? I haven't used eyeliner in a long time, and I don't use it like that, but because like when I use my eyeliner, I just use like an angled brush with a black eyeshadow, and I kind of like line my eyes like that because I find it easier. But because this is too hard, and I haven't done it in a while, so I don't know if I want to do it today. I probably won't. But yeah, dare to be different. I'm trying to find something and I can't find it. Like, I don't follow trends. Please don't. Be yourself. Like, be yourself. This is why I can't join like certain like sororities or something, because you basically have to be, I'm not bashing sororities, but I'm just saying like you basically have to do something that other people have done to get there. Shade, no shade. I ain't throwing no shade. Now if you in a sorority, that's great, but I'm not socializing. I don't like to be around people like that. No, I don't like being around people like that. Let me put this on here. And one thing, people take these reality TV shows like too seriously. Like, I'd be on like Instagram or whatever, and it's like people really take these shows seriously, especially like Real Housewives in Atlanta. It's like, come on now. What do Phaedra and Portia relationship affect your life? It really doesn't affect your life at all. But the thing is, y'all take it so seriously. It's like, oh my gosh. Is it that serious? Like, is it really that serious? Like, these people take it seriously. Only thing that should be taken seriously is like Trump bombing another country. Now that should be taken seriously, but y'all take that seriously? For example, they be like, if blah blah blah, what you call is fake, this, like, really? So don't watch the show. It's just for entertainment. It's not that serious. It really isn't. and I just offended some other people. Who cares? Like, it's not that serious. It's just a TV show. Let me put on my wig. This do look cute, though. If I had a black silk wrap, I'd wear it like this because it's cute. What time is it? Okay, let me put on my wig and yeah. I'm gonna set my foundation. I would change my wig to a different one, but the wig that I had is like longer and curlier, and it's like I'm already hot. And I like this wig because it's not on my like neck like that. So I want to buy another one. I want to try the 4A curly, but I don't got no money because I'm a broke college student, so, and I need a job, so. Until I get some money, I will buy one. Another thing, people want to flex and they got this money. You don't. Like, stop. You probably spend your money on something that's not really relevant to your life. It's like, spend it on something, you know, start paying off your loans. Which, I have to look back at it because I think I have to pay one from in May, and I'm like, I'm still in college and stuff of it. So I sent my school verification to them, but yeah. This dude like staring at me the whole time when I'm over here at the window filming this video. He pulled up and just, I don't know what he was doing. He looked short too. Very short. Like, short, short. He started looking at me like this. What is she doing? Yes, yes. Okay, so you guys, this is the end of this video. I'll touch you guys later. This probably wasn't that juicy. Y'all need to give me some topics to talk about. I'm gonna give you the real deal, whole film, sometimes, because some things I don't wanna, because I can call out people. But the thing is, I gotta go, and I'll touch you guys later. Like, really, that little hot light thing, I probably should have put more, but it's okay. Bye, guys.